Good morning, dear students. There is a question from my side to you that what are our basic needs? What are our basic needs? What do you mean by basic needs? The things or the needs without which we cannot survive. They are called our basic needs. Okay. So what are the basic needs? First one is food, air, water, shelter, and clothes. Okay, we cannot live without these five things. What are they? Food, air, water, shelter, and clothes. Okay, so today we are going to study about clothes only. In fact, if I talk about the basic things, that how clothes are made, any piece of cloth that you see, whether it is your handkerchief, your shirt, or your trouser, or any other piece of garment, how it is formed. We are going to study about that only today, and the name of the chapter is Fiber to Fabric. What is the name of the chapter? Fiber to Fabric. Okay, so first let us know what are the basic terms that we are going to study right now. First basic term is fiber. What is a fiber? Fiber is a thin hair-like strands. These are the thin hair-like strands or filaments that are used to make cloth. Okay, if I discuss about this my piece of dupatta, then we can see that very fine strands are there. Okay, these fine strands, if we see them again, one strand if I take out, then I am going to see that some more hair-like structures are there, very thin filaments are there, which are all together. Or just take the cotton in your hand and you will see that very fine fiber, thread-like structures are coming out of it. That is actually fiber. Then comes yarn. First one was fiber. Then second term is yarn, Y-A-R-N, yarn. What is a yarn? When fibers are twisted means one fiber, two fiber, and they are being twisted like this. So twisted, then they form long strands. Okay, and that we call yarn. When fibers, they are twisted together, then they form strands, and these long strands are called yarn. Now yarn, when they are twisted together, when these yarns are twisted together, they make thread. You might have seen thread, how it sees. It is on a spool, okay, a pipe-like structure, tube-like structure, and on that thread is wrapped around it. So that is called thread. Now these threads, when they are again woven or knitted, what do you mean by woven? In weaving and knitting, there are two methods of making clothes. Weaving, we always use two strands, okay, or more than two strands. But in knitting, like your pullover or your winter wear clothes, like pullovers, jerseys, they are made up of wool and they are knitted ones, okay. Knitting is done. Mother, you might have seen your mother making woolen clothes for you with the help of some cylindrical needle-like structures. In Hindi, we call them salai. Okay, so knitting is done with one thread and weaving is done with two threads or more than two threads. Okay, so fabric is made of yarn which is woven or knitted. When the yarns are woven or knitted, we get a fabric. Now fabric, what does it mean? When we go to a cloth shop, the vendor who is selling the clothes, and they are having cloth is unstitched. It is unstitched piece of a long, very long, in meters we measure, and we say that to the vendor that please give 2 meter of cloth or 3 meter of cloth. Okay, so what is it actually? We are taking unstitched that fabric, and that is called cloth. And cloth is used, it is different pieces of cloth or fabric are stitched together with the help of a thread. Okay, like your shirt piece, like your trouser, or like any other garment that we can talk about. Okay, like skirts or shorts, these are garments. Okay, so they are stitched out of fabric. Fine, these are the basic things that we are talking here. So what is fiber, yarn, thread, fabric, cloth? Okay, these are the basic terms or important terms that we need to know. So first homework for today will be define fiber, yarn, thread, fabric and cloth. Okay, today this much only we will do.